Whoa.
I think what the kids leave with is they come inspired that science is creative, it's exciting, it's relevant, it's different, it's not about memorization of things.
Okay, so we predicted that one was gonna go.
It's learning by doing. It's exploring.
If it's glowing green, okay, so you
can test that out and give you a plasmid. I'm Julianne Zedalis. I teach at the Bishop School, which is in La Jolla, California, and I teach AP Bio. I'm the lead instructor for AP Bio. The hardest thing about inquiry is really for the teacher to get the shift from a teacher-directed point of view, a teacher-directed approach, to a student-directed inquiry-based approach. And it comes back, the whole purpose of inquiry is when students start acting like scientists, they start thinking like scientists. And it's in the process. The pre-lab is I have them making diagrams to show me transformation using the PGLO plasmid, what they would expect to happen, and the procedure. There's many different levels of inquiry.
Perfect.
And at this level, it's student-directed, inquiry-based, but teacher-guided.
So that'll be open for you to do?
On the first day, we literally have them just go through the basic protocol.
We're going to be looking at how organisms can be transformed to express new genes.
First thing, always safety issues.
Do you think you may need to put these on?
And I think that's what teachers can do. Instead of making bullet statements, put everything you possibly can into the form of a question.
What do you think would happen if you left the tubes back in the water bath that's hot for too long? Kill the bacteria. What else? I heard a good word. You could denature any enzymes that are involved, okay?
So this one's gonna be the control, then we have the experiment.
I'm gonna go check the hot bath. You guys live like
What's the challenge here when you have plasmid and bacterial cells? What's the challenge? A couple different challenges.
Making the bacteria and the plasmid compact.
Yes, okay. You ready for the PGLO? I will bring it. There it is. There I see it.
Okay,
put it in there. And now shake it in there. You've just dropped your plasmid in there. Awesome.
We want them to spread out evenly so they can grow.
What do you think might be a more effective way to label these plates? Guys, excellent work today. See you tomorrow, and hopefully we'll get some results.
This is PGLO minus.
They're really excited when they come in day two because they know if they have transformed cells, the cells will glow in the dark.
No.
How about the next plate?
Ah. Whoa.
Well, that one's actually.
That one grew so much more, too.
So then they get to count their colonies. They quantify their results, number of transformants per milligram of DNA plasmid, and they come up with the transformation efficiency.
Hey. What pattern is emerging here?
You know, if I see them making mistakes with the calculations, maybe they're putting the decimal place in the wrong spot, I let it go because part of inquiry is also letting them self-correct.
I think what our group made was we used 0.08, which is the density, instead of 0.8.
I don't want to make a pun, but is that a significant difference? Okay.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, take it out.
Okay, restart it.
So then the next day, they come in and they're ready to perform their independent investigations.
So today we're going to change up some variables. So for homework last night, what variables did you come up with that we can start to generate a list here on the board?
The time that we heat it for.
Time, okay.
Add less nutrient broth.
A change in temperature with the ice bath and the incubator.
If we have increased the PGLO, get in faster, so we 12 hours as for the incubation time.
It'll double the amount of effectiveness of it.
Yeah, do you think it's going to glow more than it did last time?
Yeah. I bet there will be more low colonies.
So if we didn't do that and we just left it in the room temp could close it, but probably at a slower rate, so then more of the plasmid would get out, and then it would have a lower transmission.
And look at what you just connected. But I like it that, you know, as you were thinking, now that you're more familiar with the procedure, okay, what might not we have done? And all of a sudden you came up, God, remember that when we seemed to put too much on one plate and not on the other? And that's fine, okay? You won't make that mistake again. No? Okay? Awesome. Okay.
And then you'll see these little things. What are they called?
Satellites.
Satellites.
Well, we finish the student-directed inquiry, and that's when I really get the different groups involved. That leads to some great discussions.
So they were transformed, but certainly not as efficiently. Why do you think that would be?
Because the pre-incubation step kind of serves to help tighten up the membrane here, so that when you heat shock it, it separates.
What could happen at 75? What could happen at 100? What would you predict?
I would predict that the higher the temperature, the fewer colonies would grow. It would kill off more, because if you're already at 65 and you have less colonies in your control, then you know that you've already gone past that peak efficiency.
Sure. And that would be really interesting. You know, how high can the temperature go before that's it?
Or is it just one decimal place off?
I know, but I think that's why these values aren't big enough. For your control, then, it would be
8, and then this one would be 8. Okay,
so let's try that. Wait, isn't it 95 divided by this number?
You know, one thing that I stress in my classroom is every fact that you find in a textbook, there was some kind of investigation behind that information.
That looked good.
I'll go write this up.
So that's what I tell them, that you are not just learning information, you are actually creating information. They have become engaged students who can problem solve, students who can think things through, students that can look at novel situations and apply it to past knowledge. These are lifelong skills, and I think at the end of the day, that's what teaching is all about.